What's up, clubbers? Welcome back to Web3 Club. Today, what we're going to discuss is how to sign any sort of message using an Ethereum wallet like MetaMask. Why is this important? Well, this is how you will sort of end up building a whitelist for whatever project that you want to do. And whitelists are pretty common. That it's a huge ask in my Discord channel. By the way, if you're not in my Discord channel, please hop on. I try to answer all the questions over there as well as in the comment section. So this is going to be a multi-part series where in the end we finally create a whitelist which can be updated without paying any gas. Today's video is going to be very simple. Today I'm just going to explain how do we sign a message and how do we recover who has signed a specific message. But before we get started, please make sure to hit that subscribe button, like this video, comment. Please comment. I really love reading your comments and I try to respond to most of them. And if you're looking for more interaction with me or the broader community, join my Discord. The link is in bio. Description. The link is in description. With that said, let's get started. So first things first, I have written a very simple application over here where I have sort of imported Web3 and then I sort of written the code to connect to the wallet like MetaMask over here. So once the connection is made, we create a Web3 object. We get the accounts, we select the first account and we set that address over here. As you can see, wallet address, ID wallet address, and the value, that text content that we put is the account address. I've added one more button over here, which, you know, on click calls this function called sign message. And in the sign message, what we do is we basically try to sign a specific message. Now, what is that message? That message is a simple text signing message in wallet, and we also send the account through which we want to sign this message. Once the user signs the message, we receive the signature and we just console.log it. So just to show this in action, I open the console and I click on sign message. A pop-up comes which basically is asking me to sign this specific message, and I click on sign, and after clicking on sign, I receive this output in console which is signature and then the complete signature. Now, what is actually going on? What is this signature? So if you want to understand deeply what's going on, you need to learn a bunch of cryptography. I'm not interested in teaching that right now because it's going to take a lot of time. I'm an application developer. You're here to create an application. Let's just use the tools that we already have. What actually happened is MetaMask sort of used our private key to sign the message that we sent, which was signing message in wallet. And after signing that message, it sort of gave us the output of that signing process, that signature from that signing of the message. Using this message and the signature, we can figure out what was the address of the wallet which has signed that message. And how do we do that? Let me just copy this signature over here, write it down. So I've sort of copied the signature in this variable called s, and now I open the Web3 documentation. Here you can see I've already opened the sign which I basically used to sign the message, and then the thing that I need is EC recover. So with EC recover, what I can do is I can pass the data that was signed, the message that was signed, and the signature that we received. And with this data, what I'll get back is the address which has signed this message. So let's see this in action. web3.eth.personal.ecrecover. All right, now I can add the message over here because it's a variable in my JavaScript. And I can also add the signature over here and I can await the whole thing. I press enter and voila, it returns a specific address. Now I can just copy the address and command F, and you can see that the address is the same as my wallet address. Great, but what do you do with this? So one biggest use case of this is to sign in a user, authenticate a user into your application. So for example, let us create a button called login. All right. So whenever I click this login button, what should happen is our JavaScript should send to the server our wallet address. And in return, the server should respond with a message. This message should ideally be unique to this wallet address and this session, because we're trying to create a session. Once JavaScript receives that message, what they will do is they will ask the user to sign that message, and then we will send the signature back to the server with the wallet address. Now what server needs to do is EC recover that signature, figure out the public address of that signature, the signature that it has received with the message, and if that is equal to the wallet address, if the value is the same, the public result is the same as the wallet address, then basically the user is who they are trying to say they are. And in that case, we give them a token, which the client will sort of save and use for authenticated requests. So in case everything was a little confusing, I have written everything down in steps over here. So what happens is client receives address from wallet. At this point, you might ask, why do we even need to make sure that the address is the correct, the wallet address is the correct address, wallet has given the correct address? Well, because it's on the client side, right? So I can just write an extension and just provide any address to the client, and client will just simply believe that and just give anybody authenticated access to their application, which is not the correct thing that we want. So this is why we need to sort of sign using the private keys from the wallet. So client receives address from wallet, then what client does is client sends this address to the server and receives a unique message to sign. This unique message, then client gives it to the wallet, and wallet sort of gives a pop-up asking the user to sign the specific message, and the wallet also shows that message to the user. If the user signs that message, the wallet returns the signature to the client that this is the signature the user has signed the message with. And because this was a genuine user, they would have a private key in their wallet with which they have signed it. Client sends this address, the signature, and the message back to the server saying, boss, this is the signature for this specific message, and the person who's claiming to sign this message has this address. So make sure that the three things are same, and if they are, just return the token to me, or the set a specific cookie or a session for me. The server uses EC recover on the message and signature, and it gets an address, and it then makes sure that the address is same as the one the client is asking authentication for. If they are the same, the server returns with an authenticated token, or sets the cookie, that means that the user is authenticated, or sets the session, which basically means the user is authenticated and has now logged in into the application. OpenSea sort of does a very similar thing where they also get you to sign. So here I am on OpenSea, and let's assume I want to change this address, this name. Okay, now OpenSea has just read directly from my MetaMask because I've given this permission earlier, and it has sort of shown that this is my account. But let's say I want to change some setting. In that case, first OpenSea will authenticate me. This is the wallet address that they have sent. This is the nonce they have sent. So OpenSea sent, the client OpenSea sent data to the server saying that this user wants to make some changes. Please send me a message so that I can get that person to sign this message. Once I click on sign, the server will receive back the signature with all the data. The server will make sure that the signature is of the wallet which is requesting to make the changes. And if it matches, only in that case it will let me in and make changes. So I click on sign. It has made sure on the server side that everything's fine, and now I'm logged in. I can change any of these things, but I don't want to right now, so I'll just go back to profile. And now you will see that I'm sort of logged in. I don't need to press sign again and again. So this is how signing using a Ethereum wallet works. Now, how will you run EC recover on the server? So to do that, if you're running Node.js, you can simply install the Web3 library, and then the steps are pretty similar, except that for the provider, you will need to sort of sign up with a provider like Infura and then provide their endpoints over here. Otherwise, nothing else changes. You will create a Web3 object, then web3.eth.personal.ec recover with the message and the signature. Just for completeness sake, what I'll do is I'll also show you how to recover a message. And we already have a signature and we already have a message. So what we need to do is basically await web3.eth.personal.ec recover message and then signature. This will be the recovered address, and then we can console.log recovered address is recovered address. If I refresh the whole page, I'll click on login. It actually should be the sign button, but that is fine. And then once everything is done, I just call recover and it recovers the address, which is, if I copy it and I can command F paste it, the same as the wallet address. So this was a part one of a big series, which hopefully by the end helps us understand how to create whitelist for NFT sales and all those things. But today what you basically learned is how to sign a message using Ethereum wallets, and then how to authenticate a user with these signatures and log them in into your applications. Thank you so much for watching today's video. Make sure to subscribe, like this video, comment if you have any questions. Hop on to my Discord channel if you have anything to discuss, and hopefully I will see you again next week. Bye bye.